with Embroidery.com. Welcome to this week's spotlight video. Today I'm featuring this amazing pattern from Stoney Creek. This is the Halloween Village. It's a collector series afghan. It is amazing. Now it is a really big pattern. It is 446 by 530, so it is really big. Now originally this pattern, now it comes in different sections. There's 30 sections. Originally, these were published in the Stoney Creek magazine from, winter of 2016 to like fall of the following year, 2017. But now they've brought it to you in this amazing book. So you get the entire afghan in this entire book. It's amazing. So let's jump right in and go over all the details. Okay, so first off, at the top, you've got these amazing crows. So you've got this amazing border that goes all the way around it. So we'll start with the border. We'll go all the way around and then we'll go into the middle. So at the top, you've got the crows, you got the middle pumpkin, and then the crows on either side. Then, of course, another pumpkin, with zigzag pumpkin, with swirls coming down. On the left-hand side, you've got, three more pumpkins, a harlequin pumpkin, and then a pumpkin with a spider, and I don't even know what that is. Spider web in it, and then a bat. And then in the bottom left-hand corner, you've got these amazing jack-o'-lanterns. There's, three of them? Three little amazing jack-o'-lanterns peeking out that are just absolutely amazing. So on the right-hand side, you've got the checkerboard pumpkin. And then in the bottom right-hand side, this amazing witch. Is that witch not just phenomenal? Oh my gosh, that witch is just amazing. And she's got to be huge. I mean, she's got to be ginormous. Oh, I love her. I mean, between her hat and her cloak. I mean, her cloak billows through like half of the entire bottom. It matches clear over to the jack-o'-lanterns on the other side. I mean, oh, she is just amazing. So then in the middle of the pattern, you've got the banner that says Halloween, which is just amazing, absolutely adorable. You've got the cute moon that's got the witch flying through it. Absolutely stunning. And then you've got two houses. You've got the one on the right-hand side, a cute little, two little building house, and then a tree. And then you've got the bigger house. It's got ghosts coming out of it. I think there's ghosts coming out of every window. There's a mummy, a vampire sitting on the porch. Then on the other side, you've got the cemetery. You've got a skeleton hanging out by some gravestones along with a fence, cute little cat on the fence. But so many details in this amazing pattern. Now, you could pick out any one of these details and just stitch it and it would be amazing all on its own. That Halloween banner would be stunning. You could just do that all on its own. As one piece for your Halloween decorations. But the same goes true for most of each of these pieces. Either one of the houses you could do individually and frame individually. The adorable cemetery, the witch in the moon. The witch in the moon would be perfect to be done individually. So you can do the whole thing all together on one great big ginormous piece of fabric, which would be awesome. Do it on an amazing afghan. And it would be stunning. But you can take elements of it that you like and do them individually and have smaller pieces. So now I have one of our local customers, Jana. She is actually going to be doing this. She has picked out this a beautiful piece of fabric. This is a 20 count, so it's going to be really big. She's going to do it three strands, over two. She's going to go over two on this 20 count, and she's going to make it into a nice big afghan. It's going to be absolutely amazing. So we will show her progress as she goes. It's going to be phenomenal. Once she gets done, she's going to do, I love how there's a black and white checkerboard around each section. So even around the big section, there's the black and white checkerboard, and then around the middle section, there's the black and white checkerboard. She's going to do a buttonhole stitch and then probably fray it. So it actually is kind of Afghani. I love this 20 count fabric. It's very soft, very plush. So it gives it that nice, soft, soft texture that would totally work for an Afghan. Now, because it is an Afghan, we're not going to use any specialty fibers like Arctic Rays or Whisper or anything like that, because we wouldn't want to ruin them by washing it. This would have to be hand washed, of course, but it still would need to be hand washed because it will be an Afghan. So we're not going to use any specialty fibers like that. But again, if you did them individually, you could totally specialty fire the whole thing out. It'd be fabulous. However, we are going to use glow-in-the-dark thread, which is going to be awesome. So do some of the ghosts and stuff in glow-in-the-dark, which is going to be absolutely amazing. So, okay, that is the spotlight video for the Halloween Village from Stony Creek. So head over to my needlework blog on Embroidery.com, and I will have this linked in there. And you can see all of the amazing, amazing details on this amazing pattern. And then make sure you check our sit and stitch videos for Janice's progress on this fabulous, fabulous project that she's just going to embark on. I think it's going to be absolutely amazing. So thank you so much for watching, you guys. Make sure you turn your notifications on. That's how you'll know a new video is up. As always, I love to hear your comments and suggestions, so make sure you leave those for me below. Thanks for tuning in. Happy stitching, and we'll see you next time. Bye.